In this video, we are going to learn about the different settings and features of the Impinj MultiReader program, and we are going to walk through the process of reading and writing RFID tags. If you have successfully downloaded the MultiReader program and connected to the reader, then we will begin in MultiReader's homepage. If you are having trouble setting up the hardware components, installing MultiReader, or connecting to the reader, please click the link below. Once you are in MultiReader's homepage, click on Configure Settings. This will bring you to Reader One's connection features. You should have Control Reader set to Yes and your IP address or host name in the next line. If you do not know the reader's host name or IP address, please watch our other video about connecting to the reader. You will then want to make sure that the reader model, operating region, and antenna hub sections are set correctly. For this example, I will be using the R420 designed for FCC regulations with one antenna and no antenna hubs. If you have multiple antennas connected to your reader and you would like MultiReader to display which antenna is reading each tag, then you will want to check the Display Antenna Port box. MultiReader also has a very helpful feature where it will explain the details of the different options that you hover over. For example, hovering over the antenna hub option will explain what would result in changing this option to yes. The different settings and options for your reader will be in the Modes, RF, and Power section under Reader 1. Unless your application calls for something different, I would suggest setting your reader mode to Auto Set Dense Reader, setting your reader power as high as it can go, and setting your reader sensitivity to max. If your application does not require a lot of read range or read sensitivity, you can adjust these categories accordingly. The other settings and options within MultiReader are designed for much more specific applications. If you would like to learn more about these settings and options, please click the link below. With all of your settings configured correctly, you can now begin to read and write tags. To begin reading tags, click on Start Inventory Run and place one or more RFID tags in front of the antenna. After a couple of moments, you will see data appear from the tags that you have read. For this demonstration, we will only be using one RFID tag. You will notice that our tag's name, or EPC, is displayed in the EPC value column. All RFID tags will come with a randomly assigned EPC from the manufacturer, and most users will more than likely want to change the EPC. To change the tag's EPC, right-click on the tag's EPC and select Write EPC. You will see two lines, one for the current EPC and the other for the new EPC that you would like to assign to that tag. As a reminder, the EPC must be 24 hexadecimal characters. This means that you must use 24 characters that are either A through F or 0 through 9. If the tag was written successfully, you will see a note saying good in the log below. If you receive a timeout no matching tags note in the log below, this means that the tag was in range of your antenna when it was read, but it is not in range of your antenna anymore. If this happens, your tag will not be written successfully. To fix this, place the tag back in range of your antenna and follow the steps to write the tag again. To make sure that the tag was written successfully, you can clear the data on your screen and read the tag again. If the tag was written successfully, you will see the changed EPC in the EPC value column. That concludes our tutorial of the Impinj MultiReader program. We discussed how to read and write tags, as well as some of the different settings and features that MultiReader offers for your applications. For more information on all things RFID, please visit our blog or our RFID Resources page And as always, if you have any questions at all, send us an email or give us a call.